couple of months ago, we had an event down in Brixton. At the end of my small little presentation that I did that day, I decided that I wanted to create a study group. The reason why I wanted to create a study group, because particularly we as young people, really need to learn about our true history. And if we don't know about our true history, then we can't see what went wrong in the past and how we can remedy it in the future. And we need to learn from the mistakes of the past and learn about the great people in the past and the great important historical events properly, and then we can go through it together. So at that meeting, I decided I wanted to create a study group. Our first meeting is this Monday, so I'm kind of extending this invitation to anybody who's sort of under the ages of 23, 24, really and truly. Anybody who's really interested in the audience, under that age, really want to come together so that we can talk, we can discuss sort of issues that are going on right now, and we can start reading. And that's the main kind of objective. Our first meeting is this Monday, the 12th of September, so in a couple of days' time, over in East London, in Whitechapel, 62 Fieldgate Street at the London Action Resource Centre. So if anybody is really interested in that, do see me afterwards, and we can talk and we can discuss in a little bit more detail. And now I want to go on to the next part of our programme, which is the closing remarks. So if we can invite onto the stage Elder Minkah, please. Can we give him a round of applause?
Black power.
Black power.
Black power.
Black power.
Well, brothers and sisters, difficult to follow such very inspiring presentation, and I have to say I'm a bit kind of out of touch, but we're gonna give thanks to the cabbage man. Because I, as a Saturday school, we're grateful for the support, because our Saturday school is in some serious financial crisis, and I'm not a person that really go out to dance a lot, really. But the last event we went to, I think they call it a padlock on key.
Yes, sir.
I said to the sister when I went, I don't know if it was a dance. And I said, what is this? She said, padlock. And she started to explain to me. I could grab a seat quick and sit down. Because I says, I'm really out of touch with all of this thing. But look, God, Mr. Cabbage Man's pushing to another level now. But you heard him, so I'm not going to repeat it, brothers and sisters. But that's kind of tasty, brother. But anyway. Sister. The queen in Zinga said, Mina no jag a simina man 19.
It's a change in our we don't say that power. We don't feel that conviction.
That's right.
Because getting this money, brothers and sisters, is taking us into areas we've never been before. But we give thanks and praise for Mr. Cabbage Man. So can I give Mr. Cabbage Man a big hand?
Our own independent fundraiser, brothers and sisters, because we're under a lot of attacks from the Saturday school. Many of you would have heard a lot of talks within the news recently about education. Everybody hear that? Yeah. I know we get to a point, we get so fed up with listening to the white man as soon as individuals turn it up, but we must listen.
Yeah.
Because they're giving you warnings
yeah.
about what they plan for us. And so the talk at the moment, they're talking about these grammar schools and reorganizing of the schools. But in truth, they're just really laying out that farm, laying out their program for that plantation for us. Because there was another story earlier on.
One voice, brothers and sisters.
They talked about Sports Direct. And within Sports Direct article, they were saying that we're now going to accept, we're going to now give our people, give the people, our workers, minimum wages. And they were being criticized for their zero hour contract. The reality is that as Malcolm X talked about the education system within, when he mentions around killing fields,
right.
We've talked about one approach of railroading our young boys into the prisons. We know 23% of our young, of our prisoners, of our men, make a lot of noise about what's going on in America, but we need to look critically at what's going on here. We're also living in an era wherever you see our people, you also see a terrible rise of teenage pregnancies. And alongside of that now, we come back to the Sports Direct. If they don't catch you in one way, they don't catch you in another way, they got all these zero-hour contract work in which that, as a result of the technology in which that now the system is moving around, they're all setting it up for us. And to make sure they don't rise up, they make sure that they put as many of our little convictions upon us. So even when we even get through the education system, you go to them and you fill out your application form and this is Mr. Kwame or Mr. Jones or Mrs. Smith or Yael Santa, and it goes, have you been in trouble before? And so this is the scenario which has been set for us. And so when we develop our education program here in the Afruika Bantu Saturday School, it's important to see the context of it. Brother Mandaka is right. We have to look at it within the context of our nation.
That's right.
We have to look at internal education for our liberation.
That's right. Yeah.
Because if we just think that we're just going to have all of these individual programs and think that that's going to solve that problem, and then we're going to petition them to really listen to our cause,
yeah.
We must be reminded of what the Right Honorable Elijah Muhammad taught us, which is that the only time the white man ever listens to you is when you put a gun to his head. Now, we don't mean a literal gun.
Yeah, yeah.
But what we mean is pressure.
Yeah.
And that pressure comes through our mass mobilizing. So when we come in front of him, we're not begging him. We're saying, this is what we want, or else. And so it's within that context we're seeking to build this movement. And so we give thanks for the contribution we had today from our brother, Rashanga, with the UNIA.
You there?
You know, thanks for that. Our young brother, Coyote, spoke on the 10-point program. That program is coming directly from the right, His Excellency, the Right Honorable Mark of the side of all the right. Brothers, that we're in the nation of Islam. When you pick up Muhammad speaks, it's now called a final call. They have what the Muslims believe. This again is coming from this Right Excellency, the Declaration of Rights of the Right Honorable Marcus Messiah Ali. So we do that now. We know where our education is coming from.
So we need
friends to have our poor things. Could Brother Paul Phoenix raise up an issue of mental health?
Mm-hmm.
And that's significant in the context of we've been attacked on so many different levels. And we must get away from this idea of just talking, because we talk so much.
Yeah.
God. Kind of a sickening of it sometimes. Because I don't mind talking to people who are doing something. But when they come and they just chat, and don't want to do nothing, it just makes me sick.
That's right.
Let me tell you. All right, and so
And so what we've got to do is, whether we want to call it, as the nation says, the ministry, whether we want to call it our task force, but whatever it is, it's got to be programmed addressing the concrete issue within our community, within the context of the nation itself. So, it's really brilliant what young Tumaini came up with and said is that we're having a study program. Because when you get on that internet, the distortion that they make of our movement, this is a challenge for you young people to counteract that. Because they're trying to slander our leaders, they're trying to slander our movement, and we gotta set the record straight. And as our older Tonga Gara said, it's this generation who has got to either fulfill this destiny or betray it. But they must fulfill it. So we give thanks for brother young Tumaini here, who's bringing out this study program now, because we need to do more studies. We need to. We need to support the UNIA. And I just end with just focusing our mind around some important actions. Because as Rashad W. says, we as a community need to have many things. But one of the things that what we're focusing on in conjunction with the UNIA and our organization coming together is the need for our own community building. We talk so much about that. My sister, the Queen and Singer, came to me today. She said, Brother Minkah, I want to give a donation to the building. And I said, you see, sister, said, not yet. Because we got to get our governance right. We ain't going to set up nothing in which we're not going to be directly accountable to our community. So when a penny goes in, we can say who it came from and what it's for and where it is. That is something we're not going to compromise around. Too many people have come into our community and come and robbed us. And so when we go now and we set up, when we talk about nation, we also have our own defense force. Because when those people come to rob us, we're going to have to know how to deal with these people. Because we're going to be put up with no more robbing of our community anymore. And we're learning the lessons from our history. So we've got our building fund there. I also want to say that we're also working in... Sister doesn't want to properly, doesn't want me to call her name, but that's all right. We're also working, bringing together a group of professionals to put forward an application for a full-time free school focusing around a pupils referral unit, because we see these units at this moment in time as, again, it's just a training ground for prisoners, right? And we've got to intervene, because if we don't reach young people, brothers and sisters, they're grooming them to destroy us. So these are the real challenges that what we are faced with, and we have got to rise to that challenge. And it's going to happen through concretizing our unity amongst each other, because we're convinced no one organization is going to resolve these issues. We've got to come together, and we got to be prepared to call out. Where's little Narai? Is Narai here? Because I'm coming to my end now. Call Narai in here, please. Because it's all about our young future now, that's what we're talking about. And so, we're talking about our building, we're talking about education, our own school, and we also need to talk about supporting what's here. Because we give thanks for the O'Cable Academy of Excellence. We give thanks for Queen Mother Moore, in which that what we work with. We give thanks for Nubia Community, African Community Foundation School. But we're struggling, brothers and sisters, and we need your support out there. We will be giving a bank account where you can do your regular deposit. But trust me, brothers and sisters, we really need that support. And for you, And for you, the people that are not aware, we operate here direct every week from 9:15 to 12:30. Anybody, although we have our science graduate here, but still, any people that can come in to get some support on a volunteer level, everybody's got the DDS grabs and sisters, they've got the things properly. Our community, I get some mix up now. Whatever it is we have to use, we'll have to use it because we want to make sure that our community is in a safe space. There was a time you could look at a black person and say, you know, am I alright or she alright? We got to move away from that these days, brothers and sisters. Some kind of wickedness is perpetrating in our community. And we got to be aware of that. We got to take off whatever you have in your eye, take it out.
Yeah.
And this is the issues in which we got to focus on. So we call for the volunteer to come forward. We call upon people that know children between the age of 5 to 16 to make them aware of the program in which we're doing. And I really want to say that, you know, we say the proof of the pudding is in the eating. Those are going to come late when I miss the presentation of some of our children. Too bad. But don't worry. Don't worry, there'll be other occasions. But there's one particular young man we want to honor today. Okay? And it's a young man that's been in our school from the very early days. And this is our young, this is our brother, young brother, Muyenda. Sorry. Tumaini. All right, we wanna honor him because when our children graduate, they go into all of these white people and everybody's clapping saying, well done. But they've done their very best to keep them out of there.
We're
the one that had to fight tooth and nail to get there. They done their very best to try and fail you. They do as best as anybody else and they pull their marks down, and then they want us to be grateful for that. No, we gotta be grateful for our community who did not give up, who still fought and still pushed. And I want to say that the aim of our side of school is not just to focus on the academic. You see, if you're just academic oriented, and academic is important, but if you don't have the knowledge of yourself, you guys will not have it. You don't have to have it. A man put a microphone in front of me the other day when I was at some Black Lives Matter event, and they said, well, what do you think about Afruika Bantu being with the changes in Cuba now, will they bring her back to America? I said to her, that woman is not only a freedom fighter, but that exposes that traitor, that sellout, not even a sellout because he was never with us, that man, that Uncle Tom, who is now put a most wanted label on our sister, Asata Shakur, and that just shows you that when we don't educate our children properly, how they get used against our enemies, by our enemy against us. So I don't give a damn how many degrees Barack Obama, no degree he's got. I don't care what professor he is, as far as I'm concerned, he deserves no respect from us if he's gonna be attacking us the way in which he's been doing. So we're honored to honor our young man who has just recently graduated in biomedical science. And we just got a little card for him in honoring from the community. I'm going to call up our little princess Narai to come and read this out for us. Come up here, give her a hand. We can't read out all of it, right? Because you know, once I start to write something, it's another book. But we're just writing out something very basic, and we wanted our little princess to read it because we want her to know where she's moving towards. Okay? He's setting an example. So go on. Oh yeah. She'll introduce herself, princess.
The best thing.
Oh, you want to introduce yourself first?
My name is Miranda, I'm 8 years old and I'm a member of Afruika Bantu Saturday School. education is the best investment, and it takes effort, faith and commitment. Oh, what a long way you have come with all your studying that's been done. We can't express our happiness. We're proud you tired and passed the test. Congratulations on your graduation and all the very best for your bright future.
I personally am going to speak to my brother Paul Phoenix. He's doing some work around mental health. Our young men, I feel like I want to cry sometimes when I see what they're doing to our young men in those places. So I want to link up with you. We want to do some work. We want to link up with the parliament. We've got to do some work. We've got to link up with the UNIA. We've got to link up with the nation. We've got to put a stop to all of these brothers. These few are good, but we've got to reach out to the majority of our young people. So please, thank you for the support from the Saturday School. Thank you for coming out here today. And please give us as much support as you can, because we really need it and really appreciate it. Thank you very much. Oh, sorry. We meant, we can't listen. We got to give him a little present as well, right, brothers and sisters? And we just, I just touched down in Jamaica and I spoke to Miguel. Now, this is from the ABSS government money, right? So we just spoke to our brother Miguel Lord, which is doing some wonderful work down in Jamaica. He just reprinted this in 2015. First edition is 1923. And we want to hand this young man here a present from our side of school. It's one of the best presents we could give to a man. The rest of his opinions of the honorable Marshall Passard.
Just before I continue, as my pops did say, obviously you have to bring up your parents. I want to bring up my mum. Mum, could you come to the stage, please? Mum's going to be there forever. I love my mum so much. I'm just going to pick her up and come to the the Afruika Bantu Saturday School and NatWest account. If you are able to support, we really do need the support of the community. So I'm just going to give out the sort code and the account number. If you're able to take it down and give any kind of support, we really, really, really appreciate it. So here's as follows. ABSS NatWest Bank. The sort code is...
Thank you, Cleve.
Everybody ready? The sort code is 602039, and the account number is 5060 17 609. I'm going to repeat that one more time. The sort code is 6020 39. The account number is 50601709, and it's ABSS NatWest Bank. We're almost at the end, so I just wanted to end by saying, firstly, thank you to everybody for coming. I've also got a few people that I need to thank. The first people that I wish to thank is the ABSS children, because this is the reason why we are here. I'm a product of the Saturday School. I'll be very, very honest with you. If it wasn't for my science teacher in the Saturday School, Gareth, in 2008, 2009, 2010, there's no way I would have got to do my A-levels, and there's no way I would have got to university. And it's because of the support. And the reason why I can say that for sure is that every week I'd bring in my GCSE biology, chemistry, and physics papers, and he'd help me not only in class, but also after class, in this very hall that we're sitting in right now. We'd sit along this thing here sometimes after Saturday School, and he would genuinely come and help me go through questions which I was stuck with, and then obviously that helped me. So obviously when I actually did my exams, I managed to get some decent grades, which went up to A-levels, etc., etc. So I really want to not only say that this Saturday School is everything, it really, really is. And so just as I was saying earlier on today, please do support. If you have anybody out there, it really does help. There's so many examples of students who've come through the school and have been helped. You know, there's no way that I'd be able to come on stage and be able to speak about people like Omowale, Malcolm X, or the Black Panther Party, or Marcus Mosiah Garvey if it wasn't for the Saturday School. And it's important that all of us know our tradition. The last thing I want to say is I just want to say a few thanks. Firstly, to the ABSS children, the parents, members, volunteers, Galaxy Radio, Amiga Radio, etc., etc. Also, I want to give thanks to a few different people. I better miss anybody out, I might get cussed, but just some people who have been here, some of them since the very, very beginning. Auntie Lorraine, Auntie Malcolm, Auntie Carol, Auntie Wendy, Eshe, Shola, my mum, my dad, Afria, Marvin, Donovan. I also want to big up Cozy. Cozy is we've been here discussing Auntie Afruika. That's actually her son. So I really do want to big up in Cozy and give him a round of applause. And last thing I want to say is that not only thank you for all coming, please do support our businesses that are here. If we don't support our own, then who is really going to support us? And let's thank you all for coming to the event today, and everybody have a safe journey home.